Hi, today I'm going to give a very brief introduction on water hammer in pipelines. Okay, so before we start, let's know some common terms to understand the phenomena of water hammer. Steady and unsteady flow. What is steady and what is an unsteady flow? Flow is called steady if the flow conditions such as pressure, velocity, depths at a point are constant with time. And if this condition changes with time, the flow is termed as unsteady. So suppose we have a river. Okay, so this is a river or a canal, longitudinal section. Okay, and this river has a depth y is equal to, the depth of water is equal to 1 meter, for example. Okay, and I was standing over here. And I experienced that the water depth here is 1 meter, and then after one day or after 1 hour, the depth is still 1 meter. After 2 hours, the depth is still 1 meter, and so on. So this means that the depth doesn't change with time, or the gradient of the depth, or the change of the depth with respect to time. We can put it like this: the change of the depth with respect to time, or the change in the velocity with respect to time, or the change of the pressure, hydrostatic pressure, with respect to time, doesn't change. So this change is equal to zero. So as long as the gradient of the velocity or the depth or the pressure is constant with time, this is called steady state condition, steady flow, or steady state condition. However, if this condition change, if this depth, if this changes with respect to time is not equal to zero, this is called an unsteady flow situation. Okay, so suppose that after 1 hour the depth has increased or has decreased. So this is becoming now an unsteady, since there is a change in the depth or there is a change in a velocity or pressure. As an example also of unsteady is a tidal phenomena. You know, tides, we usually experience two high and two low tides every 24 hours. So if you are standing over here, okay, after 6 hours, the wave or the tide will go back, and after another 6 hours it will come along to your feet again. Every 6 hours you usually experience some kind of motion of the coastline. Okay, and so this tide is also referred to as an unsteady flow. Okay, so we now got to know the difference between steady and unsteady flow. Let's move to the second term, which is called transient flow. What is transient flow? This is an intermediate stage when the flow condition change from one steady state to another steady state. Suppose that we have a pipe, okay, and this pipe has a steady velocity equal to V naught equal to 1 meter per second, for example. So the initial steady state velocity, so this is the initial steady state velocity, and I have a valve at the downstream end of this pipe. So I have a kind of valve over here. Okay, and this valve is going to close a little bit. Okay, so partially closed valve. So once I close this valve, after a little time interval, this velocity will change. So the velocity will be reduced to, for example, 0.2 meter per second. So this reduction in the velocity, okay, so I will reach to new steady state condition after time interval t equal to delta t, for example. Okay, so after time interval, okay, so after a specified time interval, the velocity will be changed in the entire pipeline to a new steady state velocity. Okay, so the the change from this situation, from this steady state to another steady state, is called transient flow. Okay, and actually we use this term transient. Many people are using this term. You know, when you travel from, like, if you travel from Egypt to US, okay, and you are going to make a transient flight over here. You are going to stop to make a stop over here in Europe. So there is a transit flight. So transient flight means that you are not, you didn't reach to your final destination yet. Okay, so transient is an intermediate stage. It is not the final stage. Okay, so it is the same as a transient flow. So let's move to the third term, which is called column separation. Here, column separation: if the pressure in the flow drops to the vapor pressure of the liquid, then cavities are formed in the liquid, and many times the liquid column may separate over the entire cross section. Actually, when column separation happens, and the pressure drops to the vapor pressure of the liquid, actually it is accompanied by very serious damage to the pipeline. To understand this phenomena, I am saying here that the pressure drop to the vapor pressure of the liquid. You know that the vapor pressure of the liquid is the pressure at which the liquid boils. Okay, so suppose that we have a pump. So this is a pump, and the pump is taking water from a sump and forcing this water, or pumping this water, to a reservoir. So this is a big reservoir on the downstream side. And at the steady state, the total energy line, or the hydraulic grid line, if we neglect the small minor losses, or if we neglect V square over 2G, the total energy line will be something like this. So this is the shape, if you are going to draw the total energy line, this is the shape of the total energy line. Actually, this water level should be here. Okay, so this is the shape of the total energy line at time t equal to zero. Okay, and this is the head of the pump. H pump here is actually static head plus summation of losses in the entire system. And suppose that this pump fails, or there is a power failure in the pump. There is a power failure in the pump. Power failure means that the electricity is cut down now. There is no electricity to provide the pump now with power. Okay, the result is that the impeller of the pump will be reduced in speed, okay, until it stops. But before it stops, let's cut this period of time. So now there is no power, or there is a power failure in the pump. This head is no longer 900 feet, and this head will be reduced. So after 1 second, okay, the shape of the total energy line will be something like this. The head in the pump is no longer 900, but it will reach to, like, here, like 670 feet, and then this is the shape of the total energy line. Let's understand what is happening here. If I draw the total energy line in this way, this means that in this section, in this section of the pipe, the head is no longer high. The head now is low with the blue line. Okay, but in the rest of the pipe, the head is still the same. Or it means that, like, there is a surge wave moving to the downstream direction. Okay, this surge wave, or this kind of wave, is propagating in the pipeline, and it is allowing sections of the pipeline to drop, to make a drop, or to make a reduction in the pressure. Okay, so after 1 second, as we said, that the total energy line will be something like this. In this part of the pipe, nothing has happened, but in the first section of the pipe, the head has been reduced a little. After a little time interval, let's go to, for example, 3 seconds, okay, for 2.78 or 3 seconds, the head is something like this. So this is the total energy line after 3 seconds. Okay, what is happening here? Still, the pump has failed. The pump, the impeller of the pump is trying to reduce its speed, so it is not maintaining its head anymore. Okay, and now the head has been reduced at the pump location to around 500 feet. Okay, and here also in this section, the pressure was like this. Now, after 1 second, it has dropped to this location, and after 3 seconds, it has dropped almost to 550 feet. Okay, and almost half of the pipe now has experienced a reduction in the pressure. So this is almost half of the pipe has experienced a reduction in pressure. This point, the head before pump fail, it was here, but after failure, it has reached this location. Okay, so the pressure here has been reduced, but still the rest of the pipeline didn't experience any change in the velocity. Okay, after 5 seconds, what is going to happen here? Let's draw it in another color. Okay, so after 5.2 seconds, okay, so the total energy line here is becoming something like this. This is the total energy line after 5 seconds. Okay, here we have to mention something. When the hydraulic grade line is above the profile of the pipeline, there is a positive pressure. Okay, so this part of the pipeline, the total energy line or the hydraulic grade line, is above the profile of the pipeline. So this is a positive pressure in this pipeline, in this section of the pipeline. Also here, so this is a, let's draw it like this. This is a positive pressure, and in this section also, the hydraulic grid line is above the pipeline profile, so the profile on this section is experiencing a positive pressure. So here also it is positive pressure. However, in the middle here, let's put it in another color. Let's put it here. However, in the middle section here, here or here or here or here or here, okay, the hydraulic grid line is less than the pipeline profile. This means that this is negative pressure. This area has experienced negative pressure. Okay, so this is a negative pressure. And you have to know that most of the pipe can withstand very high positive pressure, but in terms of negative pressure, it doesn't withstand negative pressure quite as positive pressure. Okay, so once negative pressure occurs, usually the pipe will collapse. Okay, and actually the negative pressure will be accompanied by an air cavity. Air cavity. Okay, air cavity means that the columns of water are separated. So we have two columns of water. This column of water, which has positive pressure on the upstream side, and this column of water, still there is some water here. Okay, so these two columns has been separated by an air pocket or an air cavity due to the negative pressure. Okay, so the situation when a negative pressure happened, or when an air cavity happens as a result of the pump power failure, or as a result of the pressure drops to some kind of very low pressure, okay, these cavities are usually formed, and it can separate over the entire cross section, so it can propagate in the entire, it can fill the entire cross section. This air cavity or air pocket can spread or expand in the entire section of the pipeline, leading to serious problem. So this is a column separation, and this situation we have to avoid it when we have to avoid it when we design a pipeline that is subjected to common pump power failure. Let's go now to the main subject here. We talk about water hammer. In the past, terms such as water hammer, oil hammer, and steam hammer referred to the pressure fluctuation caused by a flow change depending upon the fluid involved. Actually, caused by a flow change or a sudden flow change. When the flow changes suddenly, okay, it is accompanied by a very high pressure or a very low pressure, and this situation is called water hammer, as if the water has a sound of a hammer. Okay, so the water hammer is a shock wave that is transmitted through the fluid contained in a piping system. The most basic explanation is that water hammer occurs when a fluid in motion is suddenly forced to stop moving. Okay, so when a fluid is suddenly forced to stop moving, this water hammer will be formed. The momentum of the fluid abruptly stopping create a pressure wave that travels through the media within the pipe system, subjecting everything in the closed system to a significant forces. So suppose that we have a pipe with a downstream valve, and this valve is fully open, and the flow velocity here is equal to V naught. So the pipe or the flow is coming from here with a velocity equal to V naught. Okay, when this fluid is suddenly forced to stop, okay, when I close this valve, when I slam means I'm closing it very quickly, slam this valve. When I slam this valve, when I close it very rapidly, okay, the water here is no longer has a velocity V naught, but the velocity now is becoming equal to zero because it has stopped. Okay, and the kinetic energy here, there was some kind of kinetic energy, but now as a result of the closure or the sudden closure of the valve, the kinetic energy is becoming equal to zero. But to conserve the energy, this kinetic energy will be converted to some kind of elastic pressure energy. It will be converted to elastic pressure energy. This elastic pressure energy will increase the pressure at this section. So suppose that you are putting your hand over here, and then once you close the valve, you are going to assume that all this strain of water, this particle of water, will hit you. So this heating of water or this impact of water that was flowing, okay, it will create a positive pressure and increase in the pressure equal to delta H. And this increase in pressure will travel back and forth in the system until it is damped due to the friction in the system. Okay, so let's imagine that you are an operator at the end of this pipeline in charge of closing a valve. Okay, so we have here a reservoir. Suppose we have a reservoir, pipe, valve, system. Okay, and the length of the pipe, let's say it is 1000 meter. Okay, and this is a downstream valve that is fully open now. The velocity of the flow is equal to V naught. Okay, and this is the head of the reservoir, H naught. And imagine, as I told you, that you are the operator of this valve at the downstream, and you are going to close this valve in a short amount of time. Okay, you are basically slamming those trains. Suppose this is like a train of water. Okay, and this train was moving with a velocity V naught, and suddenly this train hit a break wall. So there is a wall here now. Okay, so what is going to happen? This train will stop moving, it will crash here to the wall, and the velocity will become equal to zero. But once it crash, it will develop a very high pressure. There will be a very high pressure, delta H. Okay, and then the second cart in the train will crash into it, and the velocity is equal to zero again, and then it will experience a very high pressure. And this surge will move, or this pressure surge or the effect of closing this valve or the effect of heating this wall, okay, this surge will travel in the upstream direction, okay, with a velocity. This surge will travel with a velocity A, which we call it the wave speed, very high velocity, or celerity. Celerity or the wave speed is the velocity of this pressure surge. Okay, it will travel from the valve or from this hole to the reservoir, and it will be reflected back from the reservoir to the valve, and so on. It will keep on going back and forth until everything is damped and until everything is settled to its final steady state. But during this delta H, this increase in the pressure might be very high, okay, and the pipe itself may not be able to withstand this high pressure, and it may collapse or it may make serious damage to the component of the system. Okay, if there is an elbow, if there is a junction, there may be some leakage in this junction due to the very high pressure that has been happening because of this valve closure or this heating or this impact of the train. So in this section now, I will talk about wave propagation, how the wave will propagate from the downstream valve to the reservoir and back again from the reservoir to the valve. So we are going to discuss the transient flow in a piping system with a constant level reservoir. So this is a constant level reservoir, okay, at the upstream end, and a valve at the downstream end that is closed suddenly. To illustrate the propagation of a wave in a pipe and the reflection of the wave from the reservoir and from the closed valve. Okay, let's make some assumption here. I'm going to assume that the pipe wall are considered elastic pipe. Elastic pipe means what? Means that the pipe will expand as the inside pressure increases, and the pipe will contract as the pressure decreases. So elastic pipe means it can be expanded a little more, or it can be contracted a little more as a result of the pressure. When the pressure is high, it will expand. When the pressure is low, it will reduce in size, or it will contract. And also, I'm going to say that the flow condition in the piping system be steady before the instantaneous closure of the downstream valve. So at time t is equal to zero, the flow condition is steady. All the velocity here is equal to V naught, and my last assumption here, I'm going to assume that the system is assumed frictionless. So the system is frictionless. Frictionless means what? There is no friction at all. There is no friction losses. Our friction losses are neglected. This is to simplify the understanding of this one. So if I'm neglecting the friction, so the total energy line is what? If this is H naught, or the reservoir head, okay, usually there is some minor losses over here, and the total energy line will go down because of the friction in the pipe, okay? But if the system is frictionless, there is no losses at all, so the total energy line will be the same as the hydraulic grid line, and it will be something like this. So this blue line is the initial steady state total energy line, since the system is frictionless. So here in this section at point 1, the pressure is equal to H naught. Here at another section, the pressure is equal to H naught. At the valve, the pressure is equal to H naught. So everywhere along the entire pipeline, the pressure is equal to H naught. The velocity is coming out to the atmosphere and is equal to V naught. Okay. And let us consider that the distance x and the velocity v as positive in the downstream direction. So here, distance x is positive in the downstream direction and the velocity is positive in the downstream direction. When the velocity reflects back, it will be negative. When it goes from the reservoir to the pipe, it is positive. I will track the sequence of wave propagation, and the sequence of event following the valve closure may be divided into 8 phases. Okay, so at time t equal to 0, the valve is fully open now. Okay, the head in the entire pipeline is equal to H naught. The velocity in the entire pipeline is equal to V naught. How about after time interval t equal to epsilon? After time interval t is equal to L over A, and so on. Okay, so I will divide this time interval. We have 8 time intervals. Okay, so what's going to happen to the wave propagation or to the reflection of the wave from the reservoir and from the valve as a result of the closure of the valve? Let's start with time t equal to 0. At time t equal to 0, as we said at this section, the valve is open, the velocity is equal to V naught in this direction, in the downstream direction, the head in the entire pipeline is equal to H naught, and this is the hydraulic grade line or the total energy line, as we said, since we are neglecting the minor losses or the losses at all. Once we close the valve, so at the time equal to epsilon, very small time interval, okay, we said that let's put some numbers here, that the pipe length is 1000 meter, and suppose that the wave that will propagate as a result of the closure of the valve, this wave has a speed A, has a celerity A, and A is equal to 1000 meter per second. Actually, this is very common for a steel pipe. Okay, the surge wave that is traveling back and forth reaches almost 1000 meter per second. However, for plastic pipe like PVC or polyethylene, it is reduced to 300 or 400 meter per second. But suppose that this is a steel pipe. So the steel pipe, when it experiences a wave propagation, this wave will propagate with a speed of 1000 meter per second. Okay, so as a result of closure, okay, once I close the valve, here in this part the velocity will become zero, okay, but here the velocity is still V equal to V naught. It doesn't feel the closure of the valve yet, okay, but here in this section the velocity is equal to zero, and because the velocity is equal to zero, kinetic energy is equal to zero, and since the kinetic energy is equal to zero, it has been converted to pressure energy. And pressure energy means that there is an increase in the head. There is a positive delta H now. Okay, so here now in this section, in the last section of the pipe, the head is equal to H naught plus delta H. Okay, but here the rest of the pipe didn't feel yet the closure of the valve. Okay, now after 2 epsilon, after time interval equal to 2 epsilon, this wave will move this in this direction. Okay, and once it moves in this direction, in the upstream direction, again the velocity will be equal to zero in this entire section. Okay, and the head in the entire in this part of the pipe will be equal to H naught plus delta H. Okay, so after a while, this wave will reach to the upstream reservoir. When it will reach to the upstream reservoir, we said that the pipe length is 1000 meter, and this wave is moving with a speed 1000 meter per second. So after time interval L over A, which is 1000 divided by 1000 meter per second, is equal to 1 second. So after 1 second, the entire pipe has experienced a high pressure. All the point along the pipeline has a positive pressure now okay, which is equal to H naught plus delta H. So the pressure has increased in the entire pipeline after time interval equal to 1 second, and also all the particle of the water in the pipeline has a velocity equal to zero. Okay, how about this dotted line? This dotted line means that since the pipe has a velocity equal to zero and the pressure has increased, there is an increase in pressure over here, we said the pipe will expand. So this is an expansion of the pipe. Pipe has been expanded, is expanded. Okay, so after time interval equal to 1 second, the cross section of the pipe along the whole cross section of the pipeline has been expanded to a new cross section. Okay, now let's see what is going to happen at time interval 1 second. At 1 second, we said velocity now is equal to zero. The head in any section along the pipeline is equal to H naught plus delta H. The pipe has been expanded a little, okay, but here actually this situation can no longer sustain. Why? Here the velocity of the reservoir is equal to zero and the velocity in the pipe is equal to zero, but the head in the reservoir is equal to H naught. However, the head at this section of the pipe is equal to H naught plus delta H. This can no longer happen, okay, it can no longer sustain. Okay, what is going to happen? Water will move from the high pressure to the low pressure. So once the water move from the pipe to the reservoir, because this is this point now has a high pressure and this point has a low pressure, okay, so the water will move from the high pressure to the low pressure. Once it moves from the high pressure to the low pressure, this line will be dropped. It will be something like this. Okay, so the pressure will drop to H naught in this section. And once it drops, the velocity here in this section will be in the negative direction. It will be minus V naught. So after L over A plus epsilon, okay, this section will experience negative flow velocity. Okay, the velocity here will be minus V naught. The head over here will be H naught only. However, the rest of the pipe still it has not been affected, but what has happened at the reservoir side. Okay, the reflection at the reservoir, it didn't propagate yet to the entire cross section of the pipeline. Okay, it happened only at the first section of the pipeline. Okay, and now this wave or this negative wave will propagate in the downstream direction. This wave will propagate in the downstream direction with velocity A. So let's see what is going to happen next. This wave, as we said, will propagate in the downstream direction, making what? Once it reaches this section, okay, the pipe will have a negative velocity. The flow velocity will be negative. The head will be reduced to H naught, and the pipe as a result of reduction in pressure will be contracted to its original size. Okay, this wave will propagate in the downstream direction until it reaches to the valve again. So it will reach to the valve at time interval 2L over A. So it took 1 second from here to here and another second from the reservoir back again to the valve. So it took 2 seconds. Okay, so after at 2 seconds exactly, the velocity in the entire pipe is negative V naught, minus V naught. Okay, and the head in the entire pipeline is H naught. Let's move to the next time interval. The next time interval, let's look at the situation over here. Here, the velocity is minus V naught. What does it mean, minus V naught? This means that the particle of water here is about to move in this direction. Okay, once the particle of water is about to move in this direction, so it means that there will be some cavity. It will leave a cavity over here. A cavity means there is a negative pressure or there is a reduction in the pressure. Okay, so once this particle of water move from this side to this side, its velocity is becoming to the equal to zero, and this will be accompanied by a reduction in the pressure. So the pressure here will be H naught minus delta H. Okay, as if there is another wave traveling in the upstream direction. Okay, and this wave, when it travels in the upstream direction, all of the pipe will experience a reduction in the pressure. So there will be a reduction in the pressure with delta H, and the velocity will convert to zero again. Instead of minus V naught, it will be zero again. And as a result of reduction in the pressure, the pipe section will contract. So after time interval 2L over A plus epsilon, this wave will propagate in the upstream direction. And again, it will reach the reservoir after time interval equal to 3L over A. So after 3 seconds, it will reach to the reservoir. This is a condition after 3 seconds. All the flow velocity in the pipe is equal to zero now. Okay, the pipe cross section has been contracted as a result of the reduction in the pressure. This is a new hydraulic grid line. The hydraulic grid line now has a pressure equal to H naught minus delta H. This is at 3 seconds exactly. So let's look at the 3 seconds. Here, as the reservoir side, the velocity is equal to zero. In the pipe, the velocity is equal to zero. However, as the reservoir side, the head is equal to H naught, constant. And in the pipe, the head is equal to H naught minus delta H. What is going to happen? This situation will no longer sustain. So what is going to happen? Water will move from the high pressure to the low pressure. So water will move from the reservoir back again into the pipe. Okay, once water moves from the reservoir into the pipe, the pressure will be increased more again. Okay, and the velocity in this section will be plus V naught. So after time interval 3L over A plus epsilon, the velocity in the first section here will become V equal to V naught, positive now. Okay, is moving in this direction. Okay, and the pressure will be higher, will be increased by an amount delta H. So the pressure here will become again H naught. Okay, and again we have a new surge wave, a new pressure surge that is moving to the downstream direction. This pressure wave will move to the downstream direction, making what? All the velocity will become V naught again. The pipe will expand again as a result of the increase in the pressure. The pressure will increase to H naught. Okay, and this surge wave will reach again to the valve after time interval equal to 4L over A, or 4 seconds. So after 4 seconds, the situation is like this. The velocity in the whole pipeline is equal to V naught. The head is equal to H naught. Let's compare this figure with the first time interval at time t equal to zero. Actually, they are the same. At time t equal to zero, the velocity was V naught, and the head in the entire pipeline was H naught. Here the valve was open, but here everything is the same. Okay, the condition in the pipeline at this time are the same as those during the initial steady state, except what? Except that the valve is closed now. Okay, so the we have come to the first situation again. We have this is the same as t equal to zero, except the valve is closed. So we are going to repeat this cycle over and over again. So this cycle will be repeated every 4L over A. Okay, so I put all the figures over here. So here at time t equal to zero, the valve was open. Okay, and then once it was closed, there will be a surge wave traveling in the upstream direction. This surge wave will reach to the reservoir at time t equal L over A. And then there is a negative surge wave traveling to the downstream direction. Okay, and it will reach to the valve at time t equal to 2L over A. However, the situation over here, the velocity is moving in the upstream direction or is a negative direction. Okay, so there will be a cavity or there will be a reduction in the pressure, and there will be another surge wave traveling in the upstream direction, and then it will move again in it will be reflected back from the reservoir and move in the downstream direction, and the situation will be repeated after time interval equal to 4L over A. So as we said, if you are here, if you are at the location of the valve, let's put it in another color. So if I am here and I am trying to draw the pressure variation at the valve, okay, so at time t equal to 0, the pressure was H naught. This is H naught. This is a reservoir level at time t equal to 0. After epsilon, after very small time interval, 0.00 whatever, okay, the time interval, the head has increased. The head here is becoming H naught plus delta H. The head is H naught plus delta H. So the head has increased. Okay, and then it will be high. Here the head H naught plus delta H. Here it is H naught plus delta H. Here at 2L over A, exactly at 2L over A, the head reached again to H naught. Okay, however, after a very little time interval, 2L over A plus epsilon, the head has been reduced to H naught minus delta H. So it has been reduced. So this is plus delta H and this is minus delta H. So the head has been reduced, and then it will keep on this until I come back at time interval 4L over A. And at 4L over A, the situation will be repeated back again. Okay, the head will be increased again, and then it will go back and forth in the system. So the head will continue in this cycle every 4L over A. Actually, we say that this time interval is a theoretical period of the pipeline. So the condition will repeat every 4L over A. Okay, this is actually a very ideal flow because the friction losses here are neglected, and in reality friction losses has to be considered, and once you consider the friction losses, you will see that this pressure will be high and low, high and low, but the magnitude will decrease by time. So there is a damping of delta H as a result of friction loss. As a result of the friction losses, there will be damping in the delta H, and we are going to reach to a final steady state where everything is stationary, the velocity in the entire system. And if I draw the final steady state condition, the valve is fully closed now. Okay, the velocity in the entire pipeline is equal to 0, and this is the head equal to H naught. So this is the final steady state condition. As I said, this is a very brief introduction on the water hammer phenomena and how we understand what does it mean, water hammer, what is a steady flow, what is an unsteady flow, what is a transient flow. So water hammer is basically some special transient flow or a special unsteady flow that is caused as a result of a huge change in the or a big variation in the flow velocity or in the pressure because of a valve closure or a pump failure or something like this. Thank you.